There's a scripture in the Bible, Proverbs 31, that talks about a virtuous woman. And it says, who can find a virtuous woman? For her price is far beyond rubies. And it goes on at the end of that chapter to say that a woman who fears the Lord shall be praised. When I think about my friend Jill, you have always endeavored to honor God in everything that you've done, in your actions. And I know you're going to do the same thing as you transition into this new phase of life, marriage. I'm so very happy for you. And I want you to continue to honor God in all that you do, because it would be successful. Samuel, you're getting my BFF. And I'm going to tell you, she has been a totally different woman since the two of you have been together. And the thing that I can pinpoint the most is that she is so honored that she has a God-fearing man. And I appreciate the fact that you are such a spiritual leader. And I want you to continue to love her and cherish her and take care of her. And I know that you guys will continue to seek God in all that you do, and you will have such a blessed marriage. So congratulations.
Take thee to be my wedded wife,
to have and to hold from this day forth,
for richer or poorer,
in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish,
until death do us part.
Have declared the same by the giving and the receiving of rings. I pronounce them man and wife together. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit, you may now salute your bride.
Heavy dose of providence. It is not by chance that you're sitting at that table with this lovely woman at this time right now. I want to congratulate you on waiting on the Lord, and I'll just end with this. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace in your home, peace at your job, peace wherever you go. In Jesus' name, amen.